Annastacia Palaszczuk has hit back at those criticising her European vacation, the Queensland Premier defending her trip, saying everyone is entitled to leave. The problem is, back home, victims of the state's youth crime crisis still haven't heard a peep from the Palaszczuk government a week after marching on Parliament with their concerns. Let's bring in the founder of Voice for Victims, Ben Cannon. Ben, good morning to you. Nice to see you again, my friend. The Premier says everyone is OK to have leave. Your response?
I agree. We don't begrudge anyone for having a holiday. But as a person that's run their own business before, you know, there's been many events that I've had to miss because I have the people that look after. So for me, it's probably bad timing.
Have you heard anything more importantly, since last week, since your march on Parliament? Because the Premier also said to a News Corp journalist that there are no issues back home, or that was the quote anyway. Have you heard anything at all?
Late yesterday, we did get a call from Katarina Carroll, who seems to be thrown at the front of this continuously, and she has indicated that we may be looking to have a meeting with the ministers next week on the Wednesday, which they're looking to organise. We've reiterated that for us, unless we get agreement before that meeting, that we will be able to create this committee, which we believe is the way forward. We don't want a meeting for the sake of a meeting. We want to make sure the meeting has substance and we can have some outcomes.
What do you think realistically is going to happen, given it seems like the sharks are circling inside her government at the moment?
We've never said this is a political issue for us. We don't care who makes the decision.
Yeah.
But the people in that building have to start making them. So for us, we've been told by Stephen Miles, we've been told by all the other ministers that it's business as usual. The Premier has said that herself. So for us, we don't see her absence being a delay. You know, I think her comments were extremely disappointing. I've had a number of people overnight comment that for her to say there's nothing going on at home, you know, to indicate that everything's okay is particularly, you know, probably echoes the sort of lack of human sort of touch that she has for the people that are feeling this. And also perhaps it's an indication without her media circle around her, maybe we're seeing her true colours.
Mm. Gee, you're not mincing your words.
Like I've said from the start, for those people in that building in Brisbane, it's a sort of political toy. For us, it's deeply personal.
Yeah.
You know, this is not a game. I mean, you guys called me. I'm grateful for the space, but I pulled over on the side of the road on my way to work. You know, this is not what I do for a living. So, you know, apologies for the sirens. You know, it's for us, it's a deeply personal issue that should have been resolved. We should have had a seat at the table years ago.
Yeah.
I think we've had a person die every month this year. So for me, it's not a game. It's something that we want to see the end to.
It's not a game for us either, Ben. Appreciate you being on. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Carl.
Sarah.
Thank you.
Queensland Premier has had to fend off paparazzi while on holiday in Italy. 9 Brisbane reporter Jess Millwood has a story for us this morning. Jess, she's asked for privacy on her holiday.
Good morning, Brooke. The Premier was not happy about being snapped at all. She was with her partner, Reza Adib, going into their hotel in Naples, Italy. The Premier travelled to meet Reza, who is speaking at a conference there. She told the photographers to go away and after doing so, reportedly told News Corp there are no issues when questioned as to whether or not she should be back here in Queensland dealing with the youth crime crisis. Those comments have been labelled tone deaf by some victim advocates. Here, her colleagues, including the acting Premier Stephen Miles, have backed her right to privacy and her right to take some annual leave. One person that thinks that she should step down from the top job is Campbell Newman, an opinion that is absolutely not surprising at all. He is the man the Premier beat at the 2015 election by an overwhelming majority. He says that she should step down from the leadership like he offered to do in 2014. But for now, the controversy in Italy has calmed any leadership tensions. The Premier taking to her Facebook saying, "I am on leave. Everyone is entitled to leave. I ask that the media respects my privacy. Stephen Miles is acting Premier. I return on September 11. It's then, Brooke, she'll be facing plenty of questions.
Absolutely. Thanks, Jess.
The Premier is under fire this morning for being on a luxury European holiday while victims of crime advocates wait on a response from the Palaszczuk government. The Courier-Mail report one in four comments on the Premier's Facebook post had negative things to say, but this morning we're struggling to find any. They kind of magically disappeared. Jane, the really? Premier says she has a right to privacy on holidays, as Tommy Tate appears, but she has a right to holidays, she says. But can anyone in the public eye really demand it?
Well, I think everybody has a right to privacy when they're on holidays. The problem is if you spend more time on holidays than you do in Parliament, of course people are going to ask questions. I think when she gets off that plane, she's going to find she's met with torches and pitchforks, and not just from an angry public, I think probably from some people on her own side too.
I think that's definitely happening. Tommy, nice to see you, my man. Thanks for joining us. You're with Labor Senator Jane Hume.
Ouch.
Labor's never looked so good, Jack. Tommy, the wolves are circling. Why don't you just go statewide?
Peter. Mate, you gobsmack me. I love the Gold Coast, and there's plenty of stirring to be done here. So, you know, there's a lot of news coming out here. I'm loving it. So, and you know,
that's not a no.
Why? You know, as Clint Eastwood, no. You know what Clint Eastwood says? A man's got to know his limitations.
Do you think she's in trouble?
Well, mate, it appears that there's some itchy knives going on in the background, and politics, mate. You know, if you're not in there in charge. Before you know it, you know, there's a tap on the shoulder and you go, what does that mean? It means you're out the door. So
all right, watch that space.
I think they're looking at it.
All right, you've had a